all too many names are lost to history. For example, in 2016, we sold an incredible Colt single action army that belonged to William Levi Taylor, better known as Buck Taylor, and as a performer in Buffalo Bill's Wild West, he bore the moniker King of the Cowboys long before Roy Rogers was ever born. Well, today we bring you an item from another such person of history. His name is William Mathewson, a hunter, scout, fur trader, and Western hero who earned the nickname Buffalo Bill long before it ever became a household name. The history of Buffalo Bill Mathewson has been documented extensively in several books, and his exploits are nothing short of extraordinary. Born on New Year's Day in 1830, his life reads like a history of the Western frontier. At 19, he was a trapper and fur trader. By 1853, he owned his own outpost in Kansas. In 1860, a terrible drought parched the land and devastated crops, leaving many settlers in danger. That winter, Mathewson earned his nickname by hunting countless buffalo to supply food for hundreds of settlers who came to him for aid. He refused all payment and is said to have killed as many as 80 buffalo in a single day to help his fellow man. He served as an intermediary with Native Americans who had great respect for the one they named Long-Bearded Dangerous Man. He helped negotiate several treaties to open Kansas for expansion and railroad service, a critical step for cattle drives in the years to come. He helped found the city of Wichita and the Wichita Savings Bank. At one time, he was the bank's president, and another, the city's police commissioner. But Mathewson's heroics weren't over. In the summer of 1864, the Kiowa and other tribes had been attacking towns, wagon trails, and trading posts. Mathewson had been forewarned of one such pending attack on the trading post at Cow Creek Crossing by the Kiowa chief, likely in an attempt to scare off Mathewson. But they don't call him Long-Bearded Dangerous Man for nothing. He and a handful of other men held off the assailants for 3 to 4 days, finally scattering them by firing a howitzer loaded with scrap and shot as the Kiowa were crossing a bridge en route to the post. Unfortunately, his messages to the post's owners to not send additional supplies weren't heeded, and so a wagon train full of supplies subsequently came under attack several miles out. Leaving his party behind to defend the post, Mathewson rode out alone, armed with a Sharps rifle and 6 Colt revolvers. He had a plan. Blazing through the Kiowa lines at a speed known only to those in mortal peril, Buffalo Bill Mathewson reached the stranded wagon train and put his plan to work. Unbeknownst to the defenders, they had been transporting arms and ammunition. Mathewson immediately broke open the crates, passed out the guns, and turned the tide of the battle. Within a year of that event, Mathewson was goaded into reluctantly attending an important dinner. After the meal, and satisfying requests to recount his tales of rescuing women and children from Native American captivity, he made to leave, but was first presented with a rosewood case. And the account reads as follows. As the case was opened, there was displayed to view a most beautiful pair of 6-shooters which had carved ivory handles and were silver mounted and inlaid with gold. The sentiment was that they were presented to him by the Overland Transportation Company in recognition of his saving 155 men and 147 wagons of government supplies. General Curtis, in speaking, said, "Nothing in the annals of history compares with the feats of bravery done by you." In speaking of the affair afterwards, Mr. Mathewson said, "You could have knocked me down with a feather when they gave me those guns with my name carved in them. I've been in tight places in my time, passed through many a danger, but nothing ever took my nerve away so completely as the presentation of those guns. I was speechless, but stammered some sort of appreciation and rode away over the starlit prairie that night, the proudest man in the frontier." With the artisan work performed by Tiffany and Company of New York, many a collector has found themselves reacting in a similar fashion. Beautifully French cased, and with a full complement of matching silver-plated accessories, the revolvers and powder flask are inscribed with his name. They may read William Mathewson, but we all know him better as Buffalo Bill, a true hero of the Kansas prairie, and a name that should never be lost to history.